Here we will see form authentication in ASP.NET. Normally, form authentication is based on cookies, since the authentication and permission settings are stored in cookies. However, we can also use form authentication without cookies by using query strings for passing user details. Basic condition for form-based authentication is to allow the user with correct credentials and also enough permissions to view certain resources. So, we need to capture their information and compare with what we have stored in the database. In form authentication, when we receive data on server end, we will compare them with the data stored in any storage method or provider. For example, we can store username and password in web.config file, a JSON file, or a database table. Now we'll see the form authentication flow. Form authentication is a token-based system. When users log in, they receive a token with user information that is stored in an encrypted cookie. When a user requests an ASP.NET page via the browser, the ASP.NET verifies whether the form authentication token is available. If the token exists and valid, ASP.NET assumes the user is authenticated and processes the request. If session cookies does not exist or not valid, then it redirects to the login form. If the user is successfully validated, the runtime is automatically configured with the authentication cookies that actually consist the ticket. The whole process of form authentication is shown in the following image. Client request in the browser. It will check whether the cookies is attached with it. If it is yes, it will check the test authorization and it will allow the access. And if the cookies are not attached, it will redirect to the login form. Then it will check the credential authentication. If authenticated, it will attach a cookie, test the authorization and allow access. And if the user is not authenticated, it will deny the access. Form authentication is used for following features. Since form authentication is implemented entirely within ASP.NET infrastructure, so the developers have full controls over authentication mechanism. Secondly, this feature can be supported by all browsers because it practices standard HTML, so no platform dependency occurs. And finally, the developer himself can determine the storage medium of the crucial credentials. These are the different reasons that make form authentication an appealing choice for the user authentication. However, form authentication also has some drawbacks. The credentials used during authentication are sent from the browser to server in plain text format. So, anyone can intercept the communication traffic. And during the form authentication, the developer has to maintain the security of sensitive details of the users, which it needs in order to log into the system. This approach also creates an extra work in form of login page interface. Now, we will see how implement a form-based authentication. Form-based authentication class resides within system.web.security namespace. There are two techniques which are used to authenticate the user manually. First, by the hardcode value. Here, user can verify the web form by specifying the username and password from hardcode value. And second, by web.config file. Here, user can authenticate the web form by specifying the username and password from web.config file. Next, we'll see where we can use the form authentication. Suppose you have limited employees in your organization and you have hosted your website in ASP.NET to provide information about your organization. If you want, only company member can access website, you have to generate a username and password manually and save it in web.config file or in your code. If you want to share secure information on website, then you have to provide username and password to each employee which you have mentioned in web.config file or code. If any employee want to see information sent by the manager, then he have to verify the username and password provided by the organization. When any employee open the website, then login page will be opened first. After authentication, the login page with username and password, employee will be redirected to main page of the website. After access the application, you have to log out. Otherwise, any anonymous user can log in as your name with the help of browser cookies. There are some attributes and elements which we can use in web.config file under authentication and authorization section. First is name. It is an optional attribute. It specifies the HTTP cookie to use for authentication. If you are running multiple applications on server, then you will require unique cookie name in each web.config file for each application. Then login URL. It is an optional attribute that specifies the URL to which the request is redirected for logon. If your login page is login.aspx, then if no valid cookie is found for authentication, then it will automatically redirect it to login.aspx. Next is default URL. It is an optional attribute. It defines the default URL that is used for redirection after authentication. You can set the default page as home.aspx or index.aspx, etc. Protection. It specifies the type of encryption, if any. It specifies the type of encryption to use for cookies. This option uses the configuration data validation algorithm, if available. Next is path. It specifies the path cookies that are used by the application. Most of the browsers at this time are case sensitive. If there is a path case mismatch, then it didn't send cookie back to the application. Next is required SSL. It specifies whether SSL connection is required to transmit the authentication cookie. You can set the required SSL to true or false. Timeout. It is a time in minute after which the cookie of browser will be expired. By default, it is 30 minutes. Sliding expiration. It specifies whether sliding expiration is enabled. Sliding expiration resets the active authentication time for a cookie to expire on each request during single session. Then credentials. It allows username and password credentials within configuration file. We can easily create custom username and password to use as an external source for authentication of web page. And authentication. It is a parent element of web.config file. It is used to identify the users who view an ASP.NET application. To implement form-based authentication, set authentication mode equal to false, set authentication mode equal to forms, and set forms login URL to your login page.